T-Mac is going to be just fine come the first game of the season. We watched him this weekend. We watched him before. He's now doing drills. He's catching everything that is thrown to him. T-Mac is going to be just fine, Shear.
He did some 11s today, Mike, and there was one play where they Noah threw a fade towards the side back of the end zone, and T-Mac caught it with one hand while spinning for a touchdown. And everyone on the sideline looked at each other and was like, he's back. Yeah. He's back. We're good. Well, he's still not going to get hit, but he'll get hit probably the ramp up like 10 days before the first game.
But I have no doubt about him putting together an All-American season. I do not have any concerns about that. It was wild watching him on Sunday where literally like the first four times that they're just doing sevens, he just catches everything. And he's doing that on good cornerbacks as well. He's very, very good.
Yeah. He's a freak, and it's like he hasn't missed a step. He did drop a pass, so I guess that's what it looks like when he missed a step. But yeah.
Are you surprised? I mean, honestly, are you a little surprised? Because especially with foot injuries, I mean, we've seen it before. Like a guy like Jamari Joyner looked like he was going to become a star after his freshman year, and he just never. Foot injuries always worry me with receivers, so that's why I was just a little bit hesitant. But he looks like he never. I mean,
they're all different. Like Jamari, didn't he break some bone that like isn't normally broken, and then he had a surgery that went poorly, and they had to send him. This surgery obviously it went well. Whatever procedure he had. Yeah, he looks like he hasn't been out.
Yes. And it's funny too, during the presser when they're talking about the tight ends and the coach just says, yeah, we'll just throw it to number four.
Matt Atkins is great. If you guys haven't seen that interview, go. I think that, you know, we talk about Babers leaving after a few years. I think Atkins is a star in the making. I think he's a future OC head coach type of guy.
Right. And so T-Mac, all systems go, my friends, all systems go. We're going to talk about that more tomorrow. And honestly, I think this receiving core fits in very well with what I think it complements T-Mac very well. Jeremiah Patterson, again, every single practice. Again, I don't care what any of the putzes say about two-star junior college player, two-star junior college player. I do not care about that. You can go to one practice and watch for about an hour and you can see him making plays left and right. He is good. He is very good. Malachi is good. There's a lot of receivers. They all complement each other very well, Skier.
I'm looking at my notes because I want to be accurate, but he did it again today. Patterson was a one-on-one. I don't remember who it was against, and it was stupid. The guy just had no chance whatsoever. I'm not sure that there's anyone on the team, including Takario, that can guard Patterson's comeback route. He doesn't lose any speed when he does it, and they keep going back to it. And it's like he's probably the second best receiver in camp. Malachi has been out. I'm not knocking Malachi, but Patterson's probably been the second best wide receiver right now.
Ooh, better than Montana?
He's been the first if you count the days that T-Mac's been out. Montana hasn't been awful, though.
Well, I mean, all right.
I mean, I know we both want to see it in a game. I'm looking because I'm annoyed I can't find it. But yeah. Like Patterson's good.
Yes.
Someone turn to me and go, how do we know he's not Jacob Cowing? And I said, let's wait for a game and then go from there.
Let's wait. But all I'm going to say is this, I'm not expecting him to catch for 1,000 yards and 12 touchdowns, but there are some similarities when you watch how they play. The suddenness, suddenness is very similar.
I mean, look, we're not ready to make the comparison in terms of skill level yet, but when you guys see him in the first game, they wear the same number. They're the same height. They're both really fast. I think Patterson might be faster.